15, hello guys, this is it. This time I'm going to teach you how to use Streamlabs OBS and how to set up a live stream via Facebook. Okay, so it is, first you need to go to streamlabs.com. And at the top portion of the website, you can see download button. You need to click that. And after you download the software, this is how it looks like. So it's empty right now, but later on, you're going to understand the function and also the purpose of this. Things that you can see here in the screen. So first I'm going to move my camera so that you can see the lower portion. Okay, that's perfect. So here on the left panel, you can see tabs here like editor, themes, App Store, Dashboard, Layout Editor, Studio Mode, and so other stuff here. So you do not need to mind all of those things here. All you need to set your focus keys in these three things that you can see lower part of the screen. Okay, so here you can see the scene. So the scene you're going to be the shuffling use later on if you're going to go to live stream. And then here the source and the mixer. So the mixer is the audio output. So if you have a camera, if you have a microphone or a headset, you can see it here. So as you can see, my mic is functioning, so I'm using this headphone. So first, here in the scene, you can modify it by, of course you can add a scene. So here I'm going to add new scene. Example, I'm going to capture the display of my computer. So this will be the going to display. Done. So now you can see you have added a scene. And then right after that is the source. So each scene has their source, and the source is the content of the scene. So you can add the source. So here the scene you want to capture is the display of the window or the screen of your computer. So you're going to add the source, and you have here many options and choices that you want to. But since you want to capture the display, so here, display capture. So you need to click this tab, options, and then add source. And then you can rename the source. But in this matter, you can remain Ari. remain the name of the source since we are capturing the display. So add source. Here you go. If you have another monitor or display or multiple display, so you can choose here. But in my case, I have only one. So there it is. And then there is a tick here that if you want to capture the cursor. So you can check, but if you don't want to capture the cursor, you can uncheck this. Okay, so if you're done, I want to check this so that you can see how I move the cursor. And if you're done, so you click done. So now you can see everything that is on the screen. Okay. So you can move it, you can resize, you can move anywhere you want, as long as it is still inside of the scene area. By the way, this is the area of the scene, the area where you can capture content of the scene or the source. Keep this screen. So now, if you want to display also image, okay. You're going to add another scene. Oh, by the way, if you want to add also a camera, so right now I'm using my DSLR camera. This is not yet a source content of the Streamlabs. This is another platform. But here I'm going to show you how to put your camera, how to display your camera in the Streamlab. So I'm going to add another scene. Let's name it camera. Okay. And then in the source, you need to add a source, new source. And then I'm going to look for video capture device. And then add source. By the way, in video capture device, this is the selections or what you can do with this, or what is the function of this video capture device. So this is the source that can capture your built-in webcam or any webcams that you have, or capture cards. You have multiple camera, you can also have those here. Okay, and then add source. Now we're going to rename it camera. Add source. So now my camera is a 4TEC USB 2.0 camera. This is the camera of my desktop. Okay, so as you can see, you can capture what your camera can capture. Okay, then click done. Now it goes. So let's go back to our display. So if you want to show your camera on your display scene, you can add another source and you can add scene on your source. And then click add, and then you're going to select the existing source, which is you have camera. Okay, now you have the camera child source. Okay, so now we can see the camera is now and the display scene. So you can also resize, move anywhere on the screen, look up in the display. Okay. So now I have already two cameras working. If you want to add another scene, like you want to add a scene for your video file or your any files that you have, or you want to put a new scene, you can add like a video file, video, and then click done, add source, and then you can select media source. So in media source, I'm going to move my camera. It supports MP4, ES, MOV, FLV, MPV, AVI, and so many other things you can see here. Compatible with the media source. And then click add source. Okay, you can rename it video file. Add source, and then you can locate your file by clicking browse. Okay, so in my case, I want to this one. So this is my video file, and then there is many options here. If you want to play it in a loop, you can check, and then. Can also adjust the speed and the color range. So if you are satisfied with the, the output, so you can click done. So as you can see, since my source is not I did not check the loop, so we're not going to play in a loop, but you're going to activate the scene. We're going to check another scene and then go back to the video scene. We're going to replay or restart the video. Again, you can adjust the display cut for the video if it is not getting on the video. You can move it the size, you can move okay. That. Okay, so there are many more that you can do here in our scene and also our source. I'm going to show you once again, this is the source. So you can add image source, color source, browser source if you want to show what the display of your browser. Media source, you can add text. And then you can also add slideshow, display capture as what we did earlier, window capture, video capture device, the camera that you're using, the audio output capture, the microphone, or you have any audio output and audio input. So there is a difference between two. So you're using you are using the microphone. Okay, so this is the description. You can capture the audio by selecting this audio input capture. We have multiple microphones. And then if you want to capture the audio of the desktop, so you can also add this source audio output capture and also the scene. So here in this side, the widgets, you can also add some widgets if you want, if you like. So you can explore this side, the widgets. So, there are more interesting options that you can select here. Okay, so now we're going to go to the live stream via Facebook. Okay, so now in this software, you need first to check the settings. So this is in the side, the left panel, you can click the setting button. And then you go to the stream. Okay. In the default, you can see this is the default the app if you are first time user of the stream now. It's how it's shown here, but if you want to use the OBS in live streaming, so you can check the stream type custom streaming server. Check that, then if you want to experience a better result, you always need to choose this custom streaming server. So in your Facebook, so in your Facebook, you need to click on the live video, create a live video, and then the Facebook will going to redirect you on the Facebook Live Producer. So let's go back to the OBS, which is still loading. So as you can see, there is a two blank box that you need to fill here, the URL and the string key. So the URL and the string key, you will need this check if you want to go live on Facebook, because Facebook will going to provide you this two important things that the streamer is asking. Okay. So now on your live producer on Facebook, you're going to scroll down. You can see there are three choices here. Three choices how you're going to set up your live stream. So here you're going to select this use stream key. Okay. Use stream key. Okay. So now, you can see in this area here, there is a live stream set up, which is now include the server URL and stream key. So now this is going to need to put on your stream of OBS. So you need to copy this to copy server URL and then paste here, and then the stream key. increase and then click done. Okay. So now, what we're going to do next is we need to click this go live. Click the go live before you're going to click live in the Facebook, because the live button here will not going to function unless you click place the go live here in the stream live. So click the go live. Click. So now you can see it's now going to it's now on live streaming already. So when you already selected the go live, it doesn't mean yet that you are already now live on your Facebook. You need also to click the live go live in Facebook so that you can synchronize what is happening here, what you're capturing here on your Streamlabs. We're going to show also here on our Facebook. So now, so this is the output, the sample output, but it is not yet live streaming. You need to click here. You want to make this public. You want to publish your live. So that's it. Oh, before anything else, you can also have the control here on your Streamlabs. If you want to switch between scenes, you need to go to studio mode. So here it is. You can click this on the left panel, studio mode. So you want to switch scene. And if you want to only view your camera, so this is the output. So here, this is your scene that you want to show on your live. So this is how your display here is your live. So if you want to display only your camera, your live, you need to click the transition so that you're going to transfer on your live. Okay, so click transition. Your camera is now transferred to live. If you want to have a smooth transition, you can also edit this by change it to smooth transition. Or you can add transition, fade or swipe or slide. Choose fade, and then the duration is 300 milliseconds. Okay, done. And click done again. So, first, you need to check this. You want to set your transitions. This is now your default transition now. Okay, transition type, and then click done. And then let's start the outcome. As you can see, this are the tricks. Okay, so smooth transition. Excellent friends by L'Oreal Paris. Who's ever gonna be a better before and after? Three steps. So you can now switch between scenes ever since you like display. Okay. So that's it for now. I hope you have learned a lot. Just bear with my grammar. Thank you. Have a good day.